Everything requires certain skills, not just by muscle strength. Because it can move 1,000 pounds with only 4 ounces. It is powerful advantage. Body weight, technique and the stance, all three combined into one. Then explosive force gave you that mechanical strength, and it doesn't matter if it is Liang's style, Feng style. It is all the same Weng Chun method. Its focus is kind of strength. Tianji means explosive slingshot. Be fast and play fast or jump. Fight fast against someone slow. While practice, Weng Chun style is necessary to develop physical. Just 12 moves. Maybe each of you knows formula. Core of Xiong Kung form is similar. When facing opponent fight like this using one-sided hand and one-sided position, go forward like this. Although this technique was incorporated into Weng Chun from another lineage, but characteristic that has one-side body position and side hand technique. Basically, it works the same. Has same effect for both methods, Weng Chun and Weng Chun. Feather Crane returns to forest. Fei Zhen, they all run like this. Circle hands. Cutting and boring hand. All are short bridges. Not this bridge. Our Shaolin Kung Fu has Chi Tong Sao, Belly Cutting Hand, Shaolin Fu Fu Quan Si Dai Ma, Shaolin Fu Fu Kun, Shaolin Taming the Tiger Fist Form, Use White Horse Stand, Fun Sao, Huan Sao, Split Hand, Circular Hand, Huan Sao, Sam Kiao, Circular Hand, Sink the Bridge, Huan Sao, Sam Kiao. This way to perform circular hand, sink bridge. Dai Ma, White Horse Stand. Sou Zeng, Gua Quan, Withdraw Elbow, Hammer Fist. It's useless to come out like this even if you practice till old age. But if you pull it out, pull out fingertips to the waist. From chest to waist. What's the benefit of this? I opened all the joints. It is useless to spread your hands like this. All requirement is that your hands don't use force. Just pull him. My joints and waist are all open. Even if you want to hit me, you can do anything. One punch down. I'll just pull these springs apart and let them out. No matter how much Kung Fu or tricks you know, it's useless. At that time, people used to say that Weng Chun style was very capable and powerful. So I got acquainted with Master Pak Chung and I decided to follow his teachings. When we practice Kung Fu, we must have a spirit to fight, means lower your center of gravity to the ground. After doing it, you will be able to feel the top of your feet. The ground is strong enough to push it up. It is there as soon as it's loosened or relaxed. Take advantage of the ground's rebounding power and bounce back again. During fight, I only have limited strength with my hands and feet. You need to hit harder. Hit someone with your center of gravity and use all your strength. Use acceleration of the movements and the torque, plus the power of your blow. It's the superposition of three forces. So applying it works completely different. This is also works in fighting. If you just watch and avoid hitting each time, you will be chased and beaten. Chasing forward will be definitely be much faster than chasing backwards. If you just bumped into me like this, gauntlet cannot be released. Chest and shoulder opening and closing. To open or close it, you need to coordinate chest and shoulders. Hand is in position and rotate sharply. Get up and shake. It is natural that you tremble when you are anxious. This is your best training tool. Just got up. That's how it started. Join hands. Wider his hands spreads out, the better for you. You can fight as soon as you put it on. Just touch and hit. Use the wet towel concept. Remember, it can be used to cover anything it encounters. Then you are ready to fight. Touch hands at the entry. Go down and beat him. If your partner stands frontally, change the hands into buckles. Slow motion. One hit, one snap. I don't have the power in my hands. It's the strength of my entire waist, hips and whole body. Just twist him to fly away. Fly and hit it down.
I know several masters and uncles presented it before already, but let me also share my idea. During fighting situation, the person with body like mine could be easy knocked down with just two punches. So in my opinion, while we are so close and if we want to attack, we have to start to pair and attack in same time. So during practice on wooden dummy, it turns out that many of our concepts are based on hitting. In fact, these are called blows. I think practicing this way has very good point of view, but it may not be possible to use it in actual combat situation. Get in position and hold it up first. How can he fight you if he can't stand still? Rooting is the answer. Occupy the position. That way he can't stand firmly and can't block his fists. When you sweep his feet, he will definitely move back. Then you have a chance to strike him first. I think this can be used more often while getting the right position. I think our style shows that it has unlimited possibilities. If you retreat, you have to repeat your action again, so once you gain position, stay in, continue to flow. It's very hard for us to use it in sport competitions, something like that. While you are attacking to get points and then retreat just to start again, it doesn't make sense. When I'm in, I'm trying to be closer to you if possible all time. Even if he wants to topple me, I won't let him.
Let's talk about difference between Weng Chun and Weng Chun. We don't teach the Sun Pai Fan, triple prayer Shibuda. We are mainly focused on Sun Kung form and the wooden dummy set, because both Sun Kung and wooden dummy set require a lot of footwork. In fact, it mainly depends on how often you practice and become better taking step by step. The footwork is a key. That means you can't succeed without proper footwork even if you follow all concepts. So we have also long bridges in our style. Everyone using long bridge have arms and feet. There will be also other lineages and Weng Chun interpretations. But besides the short fist, we also have long fist. So focus on footwork and body conditioning is a priority, because the body strength is the greatest. The footwork is relatively straight and simple. This one is called Dragon's Rider Stance. In terms of techniques, their hands like fins sound meaning to separate. While Weng Chun is three types of the moves, we have more techniques. In first section of the form, we have Fan, Kao, Taiju, Anju, Binqi, Zhang Sao, Lok Chui, which are set of repetitive techniques included in Sabian Sao form, and they are mainly used throughout each sequences. The split application. Let's say he punched me and I stay here. There's no need to block him. It's a waste of time only to block him. We simply use the rule of simultaneous block and attack. Soon as he strikes down, I will intercept it. After you're done, simply continue with the same hand. What's the name of that poetic metaphor for a rice shovel hand? Just put it here. Go down and then go up here. My hands are still in control. I don't break the contact. I control it at once. Then, because we are now in fight, once I have simultaneous control, I do it fast to win using my body weight and footwork. Section 2. Double lower hands. Then same repetitive movements as I mentioned before. In some situations, I might be controlled by opponent. For an instance, being pushed against the wall without way to escape. Just put your hand up like a cobra crouching for the nest. Shrink your body slightly and release the cobra.